Okay, we're off to a seamless start once again. Welcome to Hump Day Hymns here at Trinity St. Andrew's United Church. I am Mike McCormick. I am the music director here. I am joined today on sound, lights, and countdowns to recording Reverend James Murray, Renfrew's favorite televangelist. And my guest today is I was going to say an old friend of mine, but that has a wrong connotation. A dear friend of mine who I've happened to know for several years. There, I think that was a very good dodge.
Nice
Tracy
cover.
Tracy McMillan Ahern, who is a wonderful singer, singing teacher, bus driver, special ed teacher. Have I missed a couple slashes?
See, jack of all trades.
You're living. Just this week, my daughter, they have a careers class as part of their music degree, and they had a guy in who was a classical guitar player slash welder who told them that they shouldn't be afraid to make radical career changes. So
smart man.
Yes.
Smart man.
So when did your various things, because the singing and teaching have been throughout.
It has been throughout. I taught up until COVID. I taught and sang. Taught since I was about 19, sang since quite a bit younger.
Yeah.
Until COVID. And then, you know, c'est la vie. But, and then after the kids were a little bit older, I worked as a crossing guard, and then I worked driving student transportation. Now I'm a feeding assistant and lunch monitor, working towards being with special needs kids.
Cool.
Trying to get my diploma for that.
Yeah, see, I completely forgot about the crossing guard, which, you know, it was something I was, you know, very jealous of. You know, did you have a stop and slow sign?
I had a slow.
No slow?
Because you want everybody stopped around you when kids are crossing the street.
That makes sense. It's the construction guys that have the slow.
Absolutely.
Not a crossing guard. You hit stop. Both sides are stop. No, really stop.
Really, yeah. And some of them they didn't, but, you know. That's another story.
So Tracy was here in the summer when we were newbies at our live streaming. Now we are grizzled veterans of streaming, recording. And so, you know, I think you will have noticed some changes in our setup, in our toys and stuff. Because she's here again, we figured we should do some different material this time, because we were sticking more to churchy stuff and kind of like 30s, 40s,
stuff. Yeah.
So we're diving into like the 1960s and beyond. We're downright modern. I think some of these songs might even from the 80s. but we're not going to pull out our 80s haircuts just yet. That will be for next time.
You'll need a wig.
Yeah, I will need probably two.
Sorry.
Yeah, did you have the 80s big hair?
Oh, I had the 80s hair. The wings out to here, the bangs up to there, the can of hairspray.
Pat Benatar where you do?
It was huge. I'll show you a picture sometime.
I look forward to this. This will be the promo shot for this week. So this is a little prior to the 80s. This is a song that both of us were excited to do. I got to see this band at Blues Fest a few years ago.
Wow.
The remaining members. Of which another one has passed away, so I believe it's only Mickey who's left.
Is he even still left?
Oh, don't depress me.
Sorry.
Like we're losing rock stars every day, and we lost someone else this week. Never mind. Okay, so anyway, this is the Monkees.
I could hide beneath the wings of a bluebird as she sings. The 6 o'clock alarm would never ring, but it rings and I rise, wipe the sleep out of my eyes. His shaven razor's cold and it stings. Cheer up, sleepy Jean. Dream believer and a homecoming queen.
once thought of me as a white knight on his steed. Now you know how happy I can be. And our good times start and end without a dollar one to spend. Musician income.
Musicians.
But how much, baby, do we really need?
Cheer up, Sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming queen? Cheer up, Sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming queen?
I completely forgot Seamless. That we decided you were going
I'm
to
sorry.
First
I messed you up. My fault.
I messed up. You sang where you were supposed to sing. I joined you in excitement.
It's all good.
So when I saw the monkeys, what was really cool is that they had, because it, you know, it's the monkeys. So, like, I think they had their pick of, like, L.A. session musicians to be their backup band. Mm-hmm. And so they had all these guys that I'm pretty sure I would have ID'd every one of them. But they were all really good players. They're playing all these monkey songs that, you know, I'm sure they all were forced to listen to with their parents and stuff like that. And the drummer especially, whenever they, like, they had the big screens and stuff, so mm-hmm. I, you know, could sometimes see when they'd zoom in. And when they would zoom in on the drummer, he just had this big stupid grin on his face the whole show. Like, I'm assuming it's not really top shelf, difficult drumming, but he was like, I'm in the monkeys. I mean, I would have been the same way.
Yeah.
I'm a monkey today. So, yeah, it was good. Okay, so we're going to change gears. We're going to do a show tune.
Sounds good.
Do you want to say anything about this, or do you want to just sing it?
Not really much to say about it. Okay. Yeah.
So, correct me if I'm wrong, like, you've sang many of these songs in, like, recital yeah. performances, but you haven't done a lot of, like, actual theater shows, have you not?
No. My initiation to theater, musical theater, was with the Mississippi Muds in Croton Place. I went out hoping to get a part, just something, anything, in Guys and Dolls. And the next thing I know, I'm Sarah.
You're Sarah Brown.
So, yep. So.
Saving the mission.
Yeah, saving the mission.
Saving the mission.
But I do, like, Broadway's musicals are one of my top favorites. It won't be easy. You'll think it's strange when I try to explain how I feel, that I still need your love after all that I've done. You won't believe me. All you will see is a girl you once knew, although she's dressed up to the nines at sixes and sevens with you. I had to let it happen. I had to change, looking out of the window, staying out of the sun. So I chose freedom, running around, trying everything new, but nothing impressed me at all. I never expected it to. Don't cry for me, Argentina. The truth is, I never left you. All through my wild days, my mad existence, I kept my promise. don't keep your distance. And as for fortune, and as for fame, I never invited them in, though it seemed to the world they were all I desired. They are illusions, they're not the solutions they promised to be. The answer was here all the time. I love you and hope you love me. Don't cry for me, Argentina. The truth is I never left you. All through my wild days, my mad existence, I kept my promise, don't keep your distance. Have I said too much? There's nothing more I can think of to say to you. But all you have to do is look at me to know that every word is true.
Because I want to be flamenco. Yeah. I don't know how to play flamenco piano. I guess you. I keep wanting to switch over to the guitar on sort of the refrain, but that I don't have that kind of speed. Okay. Sticking with show tunes, and you're kind of a balladeer.
I am, yeah. Yeah, I was looking at that when I was thinking about everything we've chosen.
Yeah, but that's a thing. But I've seen you do you've done jokey ballads.
Yes, too. Yes, yes. Didn't we do
the Spamalot?
Spamalot.
Yeah.
Yes,
the song that goes like this. Yeah, which I don't think I could play and sing at the same time.
We should resurrect some.
Okay.
Yeah. Been so calm, so cool, no
he loved me, I'd be lost, I'd be frightened. I couldn't cope, just couldn't cope. I'd turn my head, I'd back away. I wouldn't want to know. He scares me so, I want him so, I love him so.
Yeah.
Flawless.
Well, yeah, right. I still can't remember words even when they're in front of me.
Maybe that's why we get along. So when we did Guys and Dolls, so I mean Tracy and I got to sing a couple songs together, and between the two of us, for us remembering lyrics when it was supposed to go back, so we were constantly singing each other's verses and things and trying to remember. Well, if you're gonna sing that one, do I have to sing yours? Because it doesn't really make sense. No, it's good. Yeah. It's
keeps things interesting.
Keeps things
and
interesting.
And we live to tell about it.
Well, yeah. Well, see, you had the more difficult songs in it. For me, it's like, I got to do the duets, but in the end, I get to sing Luck Be a Lady.
Yeah.
And it was like, because there, that was the first show I'd ever done like that, that had, like, songs that had such a life outside of the show. Like, so when was the show? Like, the late 40s, early 50s?
Maybe? I want to say 50s, yeah.
Yeah. But, I mean, Luck Be a Lady was a hit for Sinatra, and but, I mean, If I Were a Bell, I think, got recorded outside
I think
of the
it
show.
Did. So I wouldn't know because I can't remember the lyrics.
Yeah, but I mean, when we would do these numbers in the show, you could feel that sort of sense.
That's
of, wait
right.
a second, I know the song.
Yes.
And like
yes.
As soon as Luck Be a Lady, like, because it has the long introduction and people were, I don't know this one.
Yeah.
And then as soon.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, and didn't Sharon Lois and Brahms do the one that they do with, that Julie did with the girls? Oh, that's bad. You know the one that they had the dance to in the saloon? Yeah.
Oh, that's funny.
Gosh, I can't remember what it's called. Game.
Okay, so like we're still in the realm of musicals here, and I'm going to admit this is probably if not my favorite musical, it's up there.
Yeah.
And this is one if I was lobbying the Muds. Or someone else. This is the one I'd want to do. The problem is, I'm going to get my glasses in case I have to. I'm noticing as our set progresses, the font is getting smaller and smaller. I guess the problem with this show for community theater, it's a Little Shop of Horrors, is A, you need a bunch of puppets.
Yes.
And B, it doesn't have a big chorus. So it's not.
No, it doesn't.
Yeah, which I know most community theater, they want lots of involvement.
A lot of people.
That's what.
Yeah.
But
it might be a good one to do when you get back to there's not allowed a lot of people around.
Mm-hmm.
So you do a smaller cast so you can have more audience members. Just saying.
Yeah. See, now you're already thinking economically. So speaking of large casts, so like. When lockdown started, like, you were already rehearsing.
We were.
You'd already sold it out, had you
We
not?
Had sold out Mamma Mia, yeah. Yeah, I missed my Mamma Mia, guys.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had sold out, but it's on the back burner until we can put it on stage. But it's going on stage,
but it sold
from
out
what I'm
fast,
told.
Did it not?
Less than 48 hours.
For community theater, that's, like, pretty amazing.
Yeah,
so.
It's a good show.
Matchbox of our own, a fence of a real chain link, a grill out on the patio, disposal in the sink, a washer and a dryer, and an ironing machine. In the tract house that we share, somewhere that's green. He rakes and trims the grass. He loves to mow and weed. I look like Betty Crocker, and I cook like Donna Reed. There's plastic on the furniture to keep it neat and clean. In the pine salt scented air, somewhere that's green. Between our frozen dinners and our bedtime, 9:15, we snuggle watching Lucy on our big, enormous 12-inch screen. I'm his December bride. He's father, he knows best. Our kids watch Howdy Doody as the sun sets in the west. A picture out of Better Homes and Gardens magazine. Far from Skid Row, I dream we'll go somewhere that's green.
Betty Crocker.
Crocker.
And I cook like.
Yeah.
Donna. Yeah.
That's like extra layers of brilliance. Because really. Wow. Does Betty Crocker have a look?
I don't know.
Like, is there ever been
Pillsbury Doughboy? Look, I don't know.
Has there ever been a photo of Betty Crocker anywhere? I don't know. Anyway. Oh, no. Oh, okay, James got the camera to move there. sometimes the camera gets a little cranky. doesn't want to move when we go. Okay, this is the big, you know, falling in love duet. But see, for me, this is not the role I see myself in Little Shop.
You'd be the dentist.
I'd be the dentist.
Oh, yeah.
See? Yeah. See? It's the only role I've ever auditioned for, and I didn't get it. I was very disappointed.
Really?
Yeah. No. They had a guy who was a better and better known actor in Kingston and stuff. Couldn't sing.
Well, I don't know. I think he'd make a pretty darn good dentist.
Yeah. I think so. So if I have to produce the show myself just to give myself the role, that's the way you do it. Things. You know. Maybe we'll do it at church. It's a very very church. James is saying yeah. It's perfect. We'll bring in puppets up. Lift up your head, wash off that mascara. Here, take my Kleenex, wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup, don't have to pretend. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside you with sweet understanding. Seymour's your friend.
Nobody ever treated me kindly. Daddy left early, Mama was poor. I'd chosen a man and I'd follow him blindly. He'd snap his fingers, me, I'd say sure. descend. Suddenly Seymour is here to provide me with sweet understanding. Seymour's my friend.
Tell me this feeling lasts for forever. Tell me the bad times are clean washed away.
Understand, and it's still strange, frightening for losers like I've been. It's so hard to say. Suddenly, Seymour, he couldn't provide me. Suddenly, Seymour.
Depend on how smoothly I edit it. Okay. Well, maybe it wasn't perfect.
Those silly words.
Yeah. We're doing unique and special versions of these songs. Okay, we're gonna delve more into your world, and because you know you've been like a degreed music student, have you not?
Well, I've certainly taken a lot of music lessons, done a lot of courses, done a lot, you know, spent some time at Carleton, you know, doing a little time there.
did my time.
Yeah.
But you're a country music fan.
I am.
Which is not your typical thing for a music student.
No.
I mean,
not at all.
Country music fans at Carleton?
Who says I admitted I was country music?
I see. Okay.
Yeah. Well, you know, I grew up in small town Ontario, and that was what was on the radio. So that's what I listened to, and that's what I learned to love.
Yeah, because we're doing country, I'm going to need a pick.
Mm. Don't you have to have several attached?
Well, no. If we're going full rock and roll, I have like six of them, like you know, attached to the mic stand.
Yeah.
So that
yeah.
after each of my hot solos, I go. But given that I'm so cheap, I'd immediately run into the crowd and take it back.
Yeah. Now, do you have a preference of how flexible or non-flexible your picks are, or just
absolutely.
Whatever's?
Over time, I've developed. I prefer. I think it's like 74 millimeters, and I prefer this is my favorite. Here, you can feel that.
Ooh.
This is called the cat tongue pick.
Oh, ew! Yeah. It does feel so like a cat tongue. Ew!
But you know, back in the era when you know we had gigs, sometimes they were outdoors, and sometimes in summer when it was hot, and I sweat a lot, and you know.
Yeah.
These things, they can be quite frictionless, and
I
use them all the time. So, yeah.
Perfect.
Diving all over the place. So, you want to see?
Yeah, let's try it.
Yeah, no, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
Oh, I was just going to say, well, it's a Dolly Parton song.
Yeah.
And it was Dolly Parton's birthday last week.
She did have a birthday. I think she's 39.
She's 39.
No, that's...
Okay. been a while since I picked this up in the set, so let me just make sure it's close enough to tune for country music.
Got your dog back, house back, truck back.
Yeah, if I play it backwards.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, and I have to do this or else the button on my sleeve. About there?
Sure.
That's my tempo.
I'll do everything I can to make you proud to be my man, and I'll fulfill all your fantasies. I guess we're promising a lot, but for now it's all we got, and I'll stand by you through our rocking years. Rockin' chairs, rockin' baby, rock-a-bye, rock of ages, side by side, we'll be together always. And if you hold me tight when you love me, that's all I ask of you, and I'll stand by you through your rocking years. I'll be your friend, I'll be your lover until the end, there'll be no other. And my heart has only room for one. And yes, I'll always love you, and I'll always be here for you, and I'll stand by you through your rocking years. Rocking chairs, rocking baby, rock-a-bye, rock of ages, side by side, we'll be together always. And if you hold me tight when you love me, that's all I ask of you. I'll stand by you through your rocking years. I'll be there and I'll stand by you through a rocking years.
Her catalog is
yes.
Sick. Like, just the number of great and songs she's written.
So many songs she's written that nobody knows she's written.
Yeah. Yeah, Willie yeah. Nelson's a bit like that.
Yeah,
too.
He is. Yeah.
Let's finish with this was your suggestion.
Yeah.
And I was not aware of this as a mashup. And I'm excited by it.
Yeah.
Though I had it going a different way. I don't know why, but it's a mashup of You Are My Sunshine and Open Up Your Heart, but I think somehow in my head I thought it was You Are My Sunshine and then Let the Sunshine In from
Hair,
which, this is taking a little different detour.
Yeah. Now, I'll tell you where it comes from. The teacher that I work with, when I'm a feeding assistant, at the tail end of my time as a feeding assistant, it's rest time for the students.
Right.
And this teacher puts on Anne Murray's Hippo in the Bathtub CD every day. So, routine is good for these kiddos.
Yeah.
And Anne Murray does this on this CD. And I thought, that might be something different, something to do. So there's where it comes from.
Yeah. And then, again, Anne Murray, so many tunes. She covered Daydream Believer as well.
Yes, she did.
My mom had so many Anne Murray records.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, so let's do this. This will be our last tune, so thanks again, Tracy, for coming out and joining me once again. The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken. So I bow my head and I cry. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray.
said with a grin, smilers never lose and frowners never win. So let the sun shine in. They said with a grin, open up your heart and let the sun shine in. My mama told me something little girls should know. It's all about the devil, and I've learned to hate him so. I know he'll be unhappy, 'cause I'd never wear a frown. If we keep on smiling, he'll be tired of hanging around. So let the sun shine in, face it with a grin. Smilers never lose, and frowners never win. So let the sun shine in, face it with a grin. Open up your heart and let the sun shine in. Sun shine in, face it with a grin.